I could tell we'd driven into the country from the smell alone. With the reek of rotten grapes thick in the air from vineyards left to the crows. And the soil. French dirt smelled like spoiled milk when wet. And boy, was it wet. I'd never seen rain like I'd seen in France. We crept up a mound of dirt that resembled a trail, gears grinding, engine chugging, and drove right through a spot of tall trees with low-hanging branches. An occasional explosion in the distance sparkled through the leaves and shimmered like fairy lights dancing on the ground. "Where are we?" I said. Red looked out the back of the lorry, shrugging. "I don't know." I addressed the soldier. "Will you tell us now?" I asked. But he only looked straight, hand on his gun barrel beside him. Sergeant Meyer cut the engine, and I held onto the seat as we rolled to a slow stop into some thorny bushes. Goose flesh erupted up and down my arms from a pocket of static air. I heard the sergeant's door open and close, and I saw a cottage in the distance, darker than the night, with a roof that had toppled inward from a bomb. He came around the side of the lorry and unlatched the back, whispering for us to follow him. The air felt cleaner here, cold, and less wet from the sheltering trees. Quiet. The sergeant talked to Red, leaving me lagging behind as we walked toward a barn several yards away made of wood and rock.
"Are we clear?"
he said to Red, and she nodded. The sergeant shoved a medic's bag into my hands and rolled open the squealing barn door. It was bright inside, lit up by lanterns. I saw firewood stacked in the corner next to a cold black stove, and a farm boy, which surprised me. Too young to be the owner of the farm, and still too young to fight in the war.